The Queen of Spades, 1949, directed by Thorold Dickinson, starring Anton Walbrook, Edith Evans, and Yvonne Mitchell. In 1806, an army officer desperate to become rich schemes to learn the secret of an aging countess who sold her soul to the devil for luck at cards. This film was based on a short story of the same name by Alexander Pushkin. It's the cinematic debut of Yvonne Mitchell, who'd previously been a theater actor. This film has a full cast of actual characters, which is a rarity in the films that I review. Let's talk about them. There's the flawed military officer Herman, who snaps whenever he feels like he's being looked down on by others. The aging Countess Ranevskaya, who has become embittered due to the mistakes she made as a younger woman. The miserable Lizaveta, who longs to be free from the strict living conditions she must live in while under the Countess's care. The notary, who serves as a last-ditch effort to get Herman to be happy with what he has. The bookseller, who is wonderfully devilish and chews the scenery up in his one scene. The grandson of an old acquaintance of the Countess, who hilariously botches his introduction to her at an opera. And a couple of other colorful and memorable characters. The supernatural elements are fairly subdued, and are even absent from a majority of the film, which makes them even more noticeable when they do happen. There are some wonderful visuals in this film as well, such as a sequence where footage of a spider on a web is juxtaposed over footage of Herman seducing the ward through letters as part of his plan to get into the Countess's mansion. Due to the studio being right next to a train line and bad soundproofing, someone was appointed to keep watch on the roof to stall production whenever a train passed. Surprising early role? Aubrey Woods, who played the candy store owner in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Verdict: recommended. If you're seeking a thrill-a-minute horror fest, you're not going to enjoy this. But if you can appreciate a good slow burner, you're gonna have a good time. That concludes this week's review. If there's any obscure sci-fi or horror film you'd like to suggest, feel free to leave a comment below. Make sure to tune in next time for another thrilling low-budget adventure.